Formula 17. To be perfectly honest, I'm beginning to wish I hadn't brought them back. Begging for more.
Yes, thanks to Elsa.
Who?
The one who took the milk first.
Oh, yes, yes. But why Elsa?
I don't know. Well, I suppose I do, really. She reminds me of a little girl I knew at school. She was the smallest of us all, and she wasn't very good at games, but she was very bright and brave and good, and I liked her very much. Her name was Elsa.
Fair enough.
Oh, you're wonderful too, darling. After all, you're the one that did it.
Why, sure. They said I couldn't do it. But I did it.
Formula 17. You're a genius. You really ought to put it on the market.
No. You see, it would never work without one special ingredient. This. I'm not putting that on the market.
Even as babies, each had a different character. The largest one, we called her the big one, was vain of her size and strength. The second largest, Lustica, was the clown of the three. But my favorite, of course, was the smallest, Elsa. A weakling in size, but the bravest of them all. She loved to explore and investigate and examine, and there were no limits to her curiosity. In the natural course of events, she would have been the throwout of the pride, for the smallest cub in a litter rarely survives. But Elsa had no inferiority complex. All the cubs were naturally house-trained and always took great care to reach the sandboxes outside. But also naturally, there were a few accidents in the early days, and when these happened, they were most embarrassed. Unfortunately for Patty, very soon the cubs were too large for her. When they became 3 months old, their teeth were big enough for them to eat meat, And this soon meant that poor little Elsa never got her fair share. So I kept the best bits for her. George said he was convinced Elsa thought I was her mother. Whatever she thought, she made me happy by following me everywhere and keeping me company while George was away. When they grew older and needed more room for play, we put Nuru in charge of them, and they got along beautifully.
Elsa! What are you doing? Go away! Go away! Go! Get away! Go!
Getting them out of their cage for their morning exercise was never a problem.
Come on, babies.
But putting them to bed was another story.
Come back. No, run around the corner. Come back, big one.
Back, in you go.
Come on. That's it. And you.
Eventually, we had to ban them entirely from the house. To make it up to them, we hung an old tire from a tree, and Elsa particularly fell in love with it.
Beginning to look like lions now, aren't they?
Yes, and to behave like them too. Don't I remember the father was a man-eater?
You don't believe that man-eating is an inherited trait, do you?
I don't think anyone really knows.
I hope you're both ready for lunch, because I am, and hungry enough to eat a hyena.
John's just wondering if your cubs mightn't get round to eating people one day.
Oh, you're joking, of course. My lions are perfect little angels, and you know it.
Yes, but they'll be very large angels soon. Isn't it about time you thought of shipping them off to a zoo?
Is that an order, John?
You're touchy today. Have you been feeding him that lion's milk he's become so famous for? No, of course it's not an order. But it's a good idea, isn't it?
Yes, of course you're right. We've already arranged for them to be taken by Rotterdam Zoo. We're not ecstatic about it.
Why? It's an excellent zoo.
George means we're going to miss them. I know I will terribly, particularly one of them.
Of course you will. They're absolutely lovable at this age. It's a...
My fault. I forgot to shut the gates.
Heaven help the house. Hurry.
Perfect little angels.
John, be a dear and get hold of Elsa, will you? Be careful, she's not very strong.
Neither am I.